Hi everyone, this is a 2D drawing of the machine mice. There are 9 parts are here. First one is a body, second one is a movable jaw grid, screw, screw rod, washer, nut, lock nut and clamping plate. Today I am going to create the first part that is called as the body of the vise. This is the body of the vise. So this is a front view, this is a top view, this is a side view. He has taken a section AA, he has cut the machine vise exactly at this section and is seeing from this view. Okay, so this is a side view. So let us start creating in the CATIA view. If I know, see here, this is a machine vise. Already I have created this one. See here, what are the parts you need to understand first? First I need to create this. Next I need to create this pad, these two pads. Next, two oil holes, one here and another one here. Next one is two holes, two threaded holes. Next, these two wings. Next, I need to do the cutout here. So let us start doing in the CATIA V5. Go to the mechanical design, select the part design. I'll name it as a body of vise. I'll zoom this part a little bit. See here, the total length of this is 230. From here to here it will be minus 5 here. See here, minus 5 from this side, it is minus 5. So total length from here to here it will be 220, because from here to here it is minus 5, from here to here it is minus 5. So 230 minus of 10 is 210. So take the plane. Go to the profile. Just I'll draw the rough diagram of this. I'll delete this part. So in order to escape from this command, you press escape button on the keyboard. So let us start giving the dimension for this. Double click on the dimension part. Total is 220. Next, next from here to here I exactly I'll take exactly at the mid plane. So 220 divided by 2 110. Next, this height is 85 mm. Next, next from here to here is 40. Next, this is 5. Next is this dimension. This is 30 plus 27. Just I'll drag this little bit. Next, still it is not constant properly. I need to give one more dimension, that is from here to here it is 25. So this is, zoom this little bit, this is 25. Exit from the workbench, go to the pad command. I'll take a mirror extent. So total is, this is 100 mm. So nothing but I'll take 50 from the mid plane. So from the mid plane it will be 50 here and from this side 50. So because I'm using mirrored extent, next I need to create the pads here. This pad is having a diameter of 32 here. See the top view, 32, and the length of this pad is 5 mm here. See the 5 mm here. So here also I need to create one more pad of 32 diameter, and the length of this pad is 5 mm. So I'll choose this plane. The diameter of this is 32. It is at a distance of, the center of this is located at a distance of 30 mm here. So From here to here it is 30 mm. Exit from the workbench. So the pad should be 5 mm. Next, one more pad here of the same dimension. What I do, I'll use a mirror command. I'll select this. See here, one more pad is created here. I need to give a fillet radius of 5 mm. See here, a fillet of 5 mm radius here. I'll go for the fillet command. Select this. This is 5 mm. On this side also. To take this side also, it is 5 mm. Next, I need to create hole here. See here, there is a hole of 20 mm diameter. So select this. So the center of this should be coinciding with this circle. I'll use a command called concentricity. The diameter of this should be 20 mm. Exit from the workbench. Use a cutout command. Till how much it is? This hole is till here. Nothing but it is 40, 40 plus of 5, 45. Total is 45 mm. This side also I'll create a hole. This side hole is hole diameter is 12 mm. The dimension of this I need to give the cutout till what? 5 plus of 15. Total is 20. This is 12 mm diameter. And I'll use a concentric command. Exit from the workbench, give a cutout of 5 plus 15, 20, total is 20 cutout. Next, one more cutout here, a rectangle, I'll create a rectangle. Next, I try to dig the material from this. I'll choose this plane, bottom plane. I'll use a rectangle. otherwise I'll use the center rectangle. Center rectangle, the center of this should coincide with this. The dimension of this is 40. Next, this should coincide with this. Next, this should coincide with this. Select both these lines. Give the coincide command. It's not happening. Let me check once again. This line and this line. I'll delete this. Okay. Now it is coming. It is coming and sitting on this. This is 40. So I use the what centered rectangle command. So nothing but you will try to take it from the what middle. It will be 20 here. Exit from the workbench. Cut out up to next plane I'll use. So this is our cutout. If I see from the side view, there are two more cutouts are there of length of width 60 and 52. And 60 is to a depth of 10 mm and 52 is to a depth of 13 mm. So what I do, I'll select once again this bottom plane. I'll go for the sketch, central rectangle I'll use. Next, this should coincide with this. Now use our coincide command, and this should coincide with this. I'll delete once again this. First, I'll choose this and this. Okay, this is already coinciding with this line. Next, this dimension should be how much? 60. So, I need to dig the material to a depth of how much? 10 mm here. Next, once again, let's choose this. Go for sketch. Again, you create a rectangle of 52. So this and this line should coincide. Next, this and this should coincide. It's not happening. So what I do, I'll delete this command. So this and this should coincide. So length of this is how much? This has to be 52. Let me check whether it is coinciding with this or not. So this should coincide with. I'll zoom this little bit. It's not coinciding with this line. Select both lines. Give the command coincide. So it has turned into green color. Nothing but it is fully constrained now. Let me check whether it is exactly at the middle of the this rectangle, exactly in the middle of this plane. So 26 plus 26 is 52. It's correct because I have used the word center rectangle by taking this as a center. So this I need to dig to a depth of almost 13 from the base. Exit, cut out 13 from the base. After this, I need to create oil holes here, two oil holes of diameter 3 mm. This is also 3 mm, this is also 3 mm in the top view. This is 3 mm diameter. This is a countersunk hole. So I'll go to the isometric view. I'll select this plane. I'll place hole here. I'll go for the sketch, positioning sketch. This would coincide with this exactly the center it is. Not this command, coincide. Next, this hole is at a distance of what, 20 mm from this. So from this it is 20 mm. Exit from the bench. So it is up to next. I'll select diameter should be how much? 3 mm diameter. Type this is a countersunk hole. So I'll choose depth and diameter. Let us assume this is around 5 mm. The diameter of this is, let us assume, around 8 mm. Okay, see here, this is a hole of 3 mm diameter. This is a hole of 3 mm diameter. Up to the next I have taken. Next type is a countersunk. Here I have chosen depth and the diameter. Let us assume this countersunk diameter is 8 mm out taken, and depth around the countersunk depth is 5 mm out taken. Next one is, I need to create the wing here. I'll use a profile command. Simply I'll draw a line like this. Then I'll coincide this on this. Give the dimension from here to here, it is, see here, total is 120 here. So I'll take this as a half of 120 is 60, and total should be how much? 120. Next is, this dimension is 40 mm. This is 40 mm. From here to here, it will be 20. This has to be 20. Next I'll draw a circle of radius 8 mm here at a distance of how much? At a distance of 13 from this. So we move on this so that the center of this should lie on this, exactly at the midplane. So this would be 8 mm radius. Next I'll draw two lines just like this. Then I'll give the constant, that is tangency. Then this and this should be tangent that line. Next I'll go for the quick trim, remove the unwanted portion. See here, the distance of this to this is 184 here, 180. So from the middle it will be 180 by 2. So from here to here it will be 180 by 2. Next, see here. It is 154 from the center to center. It is 154. So from this to this is half of 154. So it is completely turned into green color. Nothing but it is fully constrained now. So exit. See here. There is a one more. Fillet is here of radius 13 mm. Okay, this is 13 mm. So this I'll give it later. Okay, I'll exit from the workbench. So this pad I need to give to a distance of how much? See here, it is 20 mm in the front view. So it is 20 mm. Next, I need to give a fillet of radius how much here? That is 13 here. So I'll select this and this fillet of radius 13. So this is a fillet of radius 13. Let me see on the other side. So this is a fillet of radius 13. Okay. So next, what I do? Just I'll mirror this fan. Go to the mirror command. I'll choose this. So fillet, I've not taken the word fillet. So what I do, I'll give the fillet here, this and this fillet should be 13 mm. Next, I need to create one hole here. See here, oil hole of 3 mm diameter. It is a countersunk oil hole. So I'll go for cut out. I'll go for to this. I'll go for a hole command. Position this. So this hole should be exactly in the mid plane here. So go for coincidence, and that is at a distance of how much? From this edge it is at a distance of 10 mm. So from here to here it is, it has to be 10 mm. So exit from the workbench. It is diameter is 3 mm diameter. Up to next I have taken. So I have chosen 5 mm for the depth of the countersunk and 8 mm diameter for the countersunk diameter. Prove this. Okay, I'll reduce the countersunk diameter a little bit here. Around 5 mm I'll take. Otherwise you zoom this little bit. Okay, it's fine. Here also I'll take around 5 mm. Give update. Okay. So I've created these wings. These holes, next these two pads, two wide holes, next two more threaded holes I need to create here. Select this plane. I'll exit from this. I select this, go for the hole. See here, these are the two eye holes of 5 mm diameter, the depth is 13 mm, and it is again followed by a internal thread of M6, deep is 10. So this is a hole now taken. I'll position that one first. So see here, this I'll give the dimension for this first. Otherwise, I'll use a coincide command. It is not exactly at the middle plane. Okay. So I'll take the dimensioning. So this size and this is exactly half of 100. Nothing but 50. Sorry, this is 20 mm. Next, the height is how much from the top or from this? Or from the this is 12.5. Because from here it is 12.5, from the top will be 12.5 because it is 25 total. So half of 25 will be 12.5 from here, 12.5 from the top. So exit from the command. So take the blind hole of diameter 5 mm, depth is 13 mm, it is a V bottom. Next, I'll go for tapping. Tapping is threaded. It is a M6. The depth of the thread should be how much? 10 mm. The depth is 10 mm. Hole depth is 13 mm. Is correct. M6. Thread is 10. Hole is 13. It is a simple hole. So this is a threaded hole. What I do? I'll use a mirror command. I'll mirror about this plane. So one more hole is created. Next, here I need to give radius is 10, fillet of radius 10 mm radius. See here there is a small fillet radius, okay, I have not mentioned anywhere. So if you want, you can give, otherwise I leave it here. These corners, all the four corners, I'll zoom this. This one, hold the control, press the control, and you keep on selecting the all these corners. Around 5 mm I'll give. Okay. So this is the final view of the body of the machine wise. See, I have forgotten to extrude this much. To a height of how much? 3 mm from this. 20 mm here, it is 23. So what I do, I'll select this, I'll go for the project command, I'll project this, select this, next select this. See here, so it is 8, 13 minus of 8 is 5. So I'll offset it from a distance of 5 mm. I'll go for the offset command. I'll choose all these things by holding. By holding the control button on the keyboard, and you offset for a distance of 5, enter the offset distance here, 5 mm. Next, I'll join this, otherwise I'll extrude once again. This also I'll extrude. I'll extrude this also. Next, I'll trim the extra portion. Not selecting, it's selecting now. Exit from this. So I'll use a fat command to a height of how much it is. 23 minus of 20 is 3 mm. Just I'll mirror this also. I'll select this pad. I'll go for mirror. I'll select the mid plane. So this is the final view of the machine wise. If you want, you can change the various views. Next, you keep on changing the various views. See ya. This is our view. If I see from the side view, this is a side view. Okay, two threaded hose, two threaded hose, and this is our structure now. Next one is, you change the, again one more view if you want, right view. This is a right view. If you want top view, you can able to see the top view here. This is a top view. I forgot to give a fillet radius here. This fillet radius can be seen in the what front view. This is 23 minus of 20. This is the total height. 23 minus of 20 is 3 mm fillet radius I need to give here. This is this. And next, press Ctrl and click on this line. Give the fillet of 3 mm radius. So this is a fillet.